All right, so today we're going to talk about something called forgiveness. And sometimes that's hard to do. Sometimes somebody might make a mistake or upset you, and they say, oh, will you forgive me? Oh, yeah, because, you know, it's a good friend, and it's not a big deal, and I can forgive them. But sometimes people do things, and it's really hard to forgive them, and you don't want to forgive them. And so sometimes maybe a brother or sister do something that really makes you mad, and I'm never going to forgive them. I can't do that. And maybe they don't even ask you, right? Sometimes, you know, that God wants us to forgive people just like he forgave us, right? When we ask God to forgive us, he, the Bible says, will forgive us of our sins. He doesn't say, oh, that was really bad and you have to do all these things. All you have to do is ask and God forgives. But sometimes, as people, it's hard for us to do that, right? And so, do you want to share your story, Mike, or no? I was asking Mike about examples of he and his younger sister, they got along and then they didn't get along, right, growing up. And I said, was there something she did that you didn't really want to forgive her for? Which he eventually did, but he had a few, one at least.
Which one?
Whichever one you want.
Well, just so you know, I never did anything to get her upset. I was a poor guy. But twice, I remember he chased me through the house with a knife. No idea what I did. I know I didn't do anything to deserve it. That's not funny. But yes, I did have a hard time forgiving her for that.
Okay, I'm not going to ask you guys specifics because I don't want you to have to out your brothers or sisters, but have you ever done anything that made you just, you're just mad for like a few days, right? Okay, so everybody has a story where someone upset them, made them mad, it's hard to forgive them. Hi, guys. Especially when it's brothers and sisters, but sometimes it's friends at school, and sometimes it's just, maybe it's a neighbor. You know, sometimes you can have a neighbor and live next door to them, and sometimes they do stuff that's really hard to forgive. I don't know if any of you have a neighbor like that, right? They kind of do things that you don't like. So, okay, so, but when people do stuff to us, God says that we should forgive them because he forgave us. But if we can choose not to forgive, and when we do that, it makes our life a lot harder. So, okay, this is a nice duffel bag suitcase. Just walk over there and turn around and come back. Okay? Not too bad. You can handle it. Not too heavy. Just push it back. Okay. A little harder that way. All right. So, let's say somebody at school, I don't know, takes your favorite pencil or something, I don't know, your favorite pen, or what's something you really like that you use at school? If somebody took it, you'd be a little ticked off. Nothing. Your lunch, right?
Yeah.
Your mom made like your favorite lunch. Or first, and
my hair.
And so, okay.
My teacher told me to, it's my break, if they want my lunch, say, no, you have your own lunch.
Okay. Well, let's say someone takes it from you, and it's like your favorite lunch. Like, I don't know, there's Cheetos in there or something, and they took it. And then I'm like, so that ticks you off. That makes you mad, and you're like, I'm not going to forgive them. Well, that kind of adds a little weight there, because we're not going to forgive them.
Yeah.
Maybe somebody tells a lie about you. Maybe school, who bullies you all the time. It's really hard to forgive those people. And it's like adding more weight to our... So, Gabriel, why don't you try this one? Well, we're going to keep adding to it. Can you pull it down there and back for me? You can try it. I don't think that you're not going to fall. That's actually not too bad. That's just a couple things, right? It is okay. It's a little bit of work, but he can still move it, right? It's not too awfully bad, but it's a little more work than it was before. Okay? Sometimes there's just some big things in life people do to us, and we just feel like we cannot forgive that. And even though God tells us, we're like, I don't want to forgive that, right? So here's some more stuff. Really big things, right, that people do. You want to try it with all of them? Here, Achilles, you can try it this time. Got it? Got it? It's work, though, right? It's not as easy as it was when it was empty. Little struggle, okay? All right, so a couple more things, right? And we just quit, things keep happening, and we don't want to forgive. There's a few more things. And let's just say Rachel's had just a bad attitude this week, right? And she doesn't want to forgive anybody anything. Everyone's made her mad. Not Rachel. We're just imagining. All right, Rachel. You get to pull it now. How long do you think you could pull that before you need to take a rest? Think so? Hey, she's gonna pull it to class with us too, so see how long she.
No, I'm not gonna pull.
So tell me, Rachel, is it heavy though? Really? Okay. Rachel's gonna be carrying this for the rest of church today. Okay. Huh? Yeah, let's say, so we had wheels on that, that makes it a little easier. If I put those all in this bag, it would be way harder.
It's gonna break.
It probably would, right? Because that's not even made to hold that. We're not made to hold on to that stuff. When people hurt us, God wants us to forgive. You know why? It's not saying that what they did's okay. It's letting us get rid of all that stuff that's holding us down so we can be more like God, right? Do you think forgiving people is being like God? Right? Because He forgave us.
Mm-hmm.
So it's God asks us to forgive other people, and that's hard to do, but He does it for our good, because He doesn't want us to carry that around. He wants us to be free to run and skip and play and do cartwheels and all that stuff. You can't do cartwheels if you have to take that with you. It's not going to happen.
I don't do cartwheels.
Okay. Let's pray. Father God, help us to forgive people just as You forgave us. Help us to be free of all that burden so that we can live the great life that You have for us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you.